What's going on, baseball fans? How are we doing? So it's one of my favorite times of the year, the Major League Baseball draft. So in this video, I wanted to go back in time and take a look at some of the best first rounds in Major League Baseball draft history. Let's go talk about it. Coming in at number 10, I have 2002. If we take a look at the first overall pick, it was Brian Bullington out of Ball State University, a huge bust. But the guy that came in right behind him was BJ Upton. Ended up having a pretty decent career. He was really good with the Rays when they got to the World Series in 2008. Ended up signing a pretty bad contract later on in his career. But overall, BJ Upton, not too bad. But the star of the show here in 2002 was Zach Greinke. Has gone on to have an insane career. A wins above replacement on Baseball Reference, right at around 75. Over 200 career wins. A career ERA of 3.44. He's still going. Drafted by the Royals back in 2002. Back with the Royals now. He has been insanely good in his career. How about Cole Hamels? This is a guy with the Phillies. This guy was just top-notch, one of the best pitchers in Major League Baseball. Helped the Phillies win a World Series in 2008. They had that insane rotation in 2011 where he had Cole Hamels, Roy Halladay. My God, what a rotation that was. And don't forget about someone like Scott Kazmir. This guy was actually just pitching recently. I'm pretty sure his career is done at this point, but Scott Kazmir, he had flashes of brilliance in his career. He was an all-star a couple of times. And don't forget about Matt Cain, helped the Giants win a couple of World Series. He was pretty solid. And then there were some offensive players as well. How about Prince Fielder? Won an MVP, won a home run derby twice. He was a six-time all-star, three-time silver slugger. His best years were with the Brewers, ended up going to the Tigers, and that's where his career just pretty much went downhill at that point. Was with the Rangers as well. Don't forget about Nick Swisher, helped the Yankees win the World Series in 2009. Even a solid player like Denard Span as well. I think 2002, when you take a look at it, I think it was a pretty fun draft overall. At number 9, I have the 2009 Major League Baseball draft. Oh my goodness, I remember going into this draft, all eyes were on Steven Strasburg. I had never seen someone so hyped going into a draft. And, you know, while Steven Strasburg is one of the worst contracts as of right now, just because of all the health issues that he's been dealing with, he did help the Nationals win a World Series back in 2019, won the MVP of that World Series, is a three-time All-Star. Steven Strasburg, when healthy, has been an extremely good pitcher. That's just the problem with him, is health. So hopefully he can get back to being more consistent with staying on the field. But the star of the show here is Mike Trout. This is the Mike Trout draft. Can you believe that this guy was not even drafted in the top 10? He was drafted 25th overall. The Angels didn't even pick him first. They picked him. They had back-to-back picks. They picked him after Randall Grichuk. What the heck is going on here? But Mike Trout, easily one of the best players in the game, if not the best player in Major League Baseball today. He is going to be an eventual Hall of Famer. He is already one of the best players of all time at only 30 years old. Absolutely insane. Don't forget about someone like Zach Wheeler. He's been having a great year this year. 8-5, 2.89 ERA over 17 starts. Man, oh man, the Phillies, they're looking pretty good this year. He's been a big reason for that. And then you got a couple other guys here like Mike Minor who have been decent. Mike Leake. I did think about opening this up at number 10, but I think just the impact of Mike Trout alone kind of bumps this up just a little bit for me, as well as Steven Strasburg. I mean, it was so fun. I remember his debut against the Pittsburgh Pirates. That was an electric debut. I think he struck out, what, like 14 guys. But for me, I got 2009 coming in at number 9. At number 8, I have the 1987 draft. The story of this draft is Ken Griffey Jr., Hall of Famer, one of my favorite players of all time. Just look at these numbers, man. A WAR right under 84, 9,800 at-bats, hit .284 in his career, 630 home runs. Easily one of the best players of all time, in my opinion. Really loved Ken Griffey Jr., man. Absolute star of the show here, but don't forget about Craig Biggio over here. He's a Hall of Famer too. So the fact that this draft had two Hall of Famers, I love me some Craig Biggio, man. Not the biggest player out there, but just a hard-nosed player. Wasn't afraid to get dirty out there. I mean, look at the career numbers that he had. A 65.5 WAR, hit 281 for his career, had over 3,000 hits, a 363 on base. He was never really like that power kind of a guy, but he still almost had 300 home runs. Easily one of the best second basemen of all time. But then don't forget about some of these other guys here as well. That's why I think this draft, even though you did have two Hall of Famers, I still find it to be a little underrated. Because don't forget, there was also Jack McDowell, who did win a Cy Young Award with the White Sox back in 1993. From 91 to 93, he was one of the better pitchers in baseball. 1993, won 22 games, had an ERA of 3.37, a FIP of 3.61. Jack McDowell, man, hey, I mean, he's not going to go down as, you know, someone like Roger Clemens, but there was a time where he was really solid. Speaking of solid, you had Mike Remlinger, one of the more solid relievers in the game during his career. In his career, I mean, look where he started. He started off in 1991, didn't make it back to the majors until 1994, and his career lasted all the way until 2006. Pretty long career, 14 years for a reliever. That's not too bad. And then there's also someone like Delino DeShields. His son is currently playing, but Delino DeShields ended up having a really solid career, a career 352 on base, had a ton of stolen bases, 463. I think this is a pretty underrated draft. Obviously, Ken Griffey Jr. and Craig Biggio are the stars of the show, but there are some other pieces in this draft as well that I think you can't forget about. At number seven, I have the 1990 draft. Let's skip ahead a few years here and let's go to 1990, another draft with a couple of Hall of Famers. You had Chipper Jones here and Mike Mussina. Look at the numbers that Chipper Jones put up in his career. Easily one of the most fun players of all time, one of the best players of all time, if not arguably the best third baseman of all time. Hit 303 in his career. 468 home runs, over 1,600 RBIs, a career on-base percentage of .401, a career slugging of .529. Man, oh man, Chipper Jones, he was the real deal. Mike Mussina, I had to deal with Mike Mussina on the Yankees many, many years, man. He caused me a lot of pain. I'm actually going to bring up one other thing in just a little bit that caused me quite some pain, but Mike Mussina, very good with the Orioles and the Yankees. In fact, he only spent his career with those two teams. First half of his career with Baltimore and then the second half of the Yankees. He was just extremely good, man. Almost 300 wins, a career ERA of 3.68. Just missed 3,000 strikeouts. But Mike Mussina, one of the better pitchers of all time. And one moment that did bring me some pain was Mike Mussina almost throwing a perfect game against the Red Sox at Fenway Park. And the guy that broke up that perfect game was Carl Everett, who was also in this draft. You know, remember Carl Everett? Pretty solid player at one point. He didn't think dinosaurs were real, but what can you do? Carl Everett, he was also pretty solid here. Had over 200 home runs in his career, almost 800 RBIs, over 100 stolen bases. Yeah, he's kind of a wackadoodle kind of a player, definitely had a personality, but Carl Everett, pretty solid. How about Jeremy Burnitz? I'm sure this is a name you haven't heard for quite a little bit. Jeremy Burnitz, I mean, if you go look at some of these seasons he had, this was a power-hitting guy. 1998, he had 38 home runs. He had a stretch there, four straight seasons with over 30 home runs. Jeremy Burnitz, man, always a power threat, had some good years with the Brewers. How about Tony Clark, MLBPA leader? Tony Clark, man, oh, man. I mean, there's some pretty decent players in this draft. And there's also Rondell White. You know, really, the top players, Chipper Jones, Mike Mussina, but you did have some solid players sprinkled in here as well. I think 1990, pretty solid draft. Coming in at number six, I have the 2010 draft. Let's skip ahead 20 years and go to 2010. The story of this draft was Bryce Harper, the chosen one, given that nickname by Sports Illustrated. And obviously, Bryce Harper is one of the best players in all of baseball. He has had himself a pretty solid career. He's won a couple of MVPs. As of right now in his career, we're looking at probably, I don't know what, another 10 more years for Bryce Harper, and he's already at a career WAR of 42.7. This guy was red hot before getting hurt just not too long ago this season. This season, he was off to a hot start, man, hitting .318, 15 home runs, .385 on base, .599 slugging. But he's approaching 300 career home runs. Would not be surprised to see him finish with at least 500 for his career. Bryce Harper, easily the story of this draft. But one guy that is in contention for an MVP this year, Manny Machado, he was in this draft as well, signed the big contract with Harper just a few years ago when Harper went to the Phillies and then Machado went to the Padres. Machado having himself a very good season this year. He's had a very good career up to this point. Easily one of the best players out of that draft. There's also Chris Sale, probably the best pitcher out of that draft. Helped my Red Sox win a World Series a few years ago. He's back to being healthy. Just made his first start this year. He's been dealing with injuries for the last couple of years. But Chris Sale, man, when you go take a look at some of these seasons that he has put together, he had over 300 strikeouts in 2017. Hasn't won a Cy Young Award, but he has been in contention for a Cy Young, what feels like almost every single year. So many good years with the White Sox, a couple of good years with the Red Sox there. Hopefully Chris Sale, he is back to being healthy, can help my Red Sox win a World Series this year. I digress. Don't forget about Christian Yelich, won an MVP award. Now, we're not seeing the same kind of production that Yelich was putting up just a couple of years ago, but Christian Yelich, man, he has really turned into one of the more solid players in the game. I would love for that slugging percentage to come back up. That's been down the last couple of years. He has a career slugging of 471. This year, it's only at 383. But Christian Yelich, nonetheless, very solid. Don't forget about someone like Yasmani Grandal. Having a bit of a down year this year, but he has been one of the more solid catchers in the game. Don't forget about Jameson Taillon with the Yankees. What the heck just happened here? I don't know what's going on. Oh, here we go. Jameson Taillon having probably his best year with the Yankees this year. He's been solid in that rotation, one of the best rotations in all of baseball. And then this draft even had Matt Harvey, and sure, I know he's had his issues over the last few years. But Matt Harvey, at one point, he was the face of New York. The Dark Knight helped the Mets get to the World Series there in 2015. There was a lot to like about this draft, man, but I remember all that hype that Bryce Harper was getting, man. That was a pretty fun time. But yeah, 2010 draft, one of the best of all time. At number five, I have the 2006 draft. The story of this draft was pitching, and more pitching. I mean, let's just take a look at some of these guys. How about Clayton Kershaw in this draft? Clayton Kershaw has been easily one of the best pitchers in Major League Baseball for quite some time. Max Scherzer, my goodness. How about Tim Lincecum? Not in the game anymore, but my goodness, this guy was so fun to watch. I loved watching Tim Lincecum pitch, even though he wasn't even on my Red Sox. I just loved watching him pitch. Won a couple of Cy Youngs, had a few World Series, four-time All-Star. Tim Lincecum, he was just, I mean, my goodness, he was the freak. He was just insane. I loved watching this guy. He put up some just gaudy numbers there. He had a stretch where he won those couple of Cy Youngs. He was absolutely insane. And then don't forget about someone like Andrew Miller. He had a bit of a rough go early on in his career. He got traded in that Miguel Cabrera trade. He couldn't really find his footing as a starter. And he ended up finding himself as a reliever. Not really quite at that same level anymore. But there was that stretch there. He was with the Indians. He was with the Yankees there. My goodness, he was one of the best relievers in the game. Someone like Ian Kennedy, he's pitching for the Diamondbacks now. He's still an okay reliever today, but he has been a really solid reliever in his career. Daniel Bard, he was out of the game for a little while. He was in this draft, but he was so good with the Red Sox early on. Ended up missing 7 years. He's back at the Rockies now, doing really well. Don't forget about Jabba Chamberlain. Man, oh man. Remember Jabba Chamberlain? This was going to be the next closer for the Yankees at one point. This guy was just throwing gas out of that Yankees bullpen. And don't forget about Evan Longoria. This guy with the Rays, man, he had some monster seasons, won a Rookie of the Year award in 2008, helped the Rays get to the World Series that year, had just some really good years with the Giants now. Still a pretty solid player for the most part, but man, this draft full of pitching. I mean, my goodness, when you have a draft with Kershaw, Scherzer, Lincecum, I mean, that's just insane, man. Absolutely incredible draft for pitching. At number four, I have the 1993 draft. This was one of the more solid drafts ever, in my opinion. It was led by Alex Rodriguez. I understand, quite the lightning rod of a player, no pun intended there with the rod. But Alex Rodriguez, his career was insane, man. I mean, just look at these numbers that he put up. Hit 295 for his career, had over 3,000 hits, just missed 700 home runs, over 300 stolen bases, over 2,000 RBIs, over 2,000 runs scored, a career 380 on base, a career 550 slugging. Easily one of the best players of all time. Steroids or not, whatever. This guy was just absolutely incredible. Very good defensively as well, moving over to third base when he went to the Yankees. Oh, still remember that whole saga, man. Still one of the more interesting stories ever, in my opinion, when he was supposed to go to the Red Sox and ended up going to the Yankees. But I digress. Alex Rodriguez, Absolutely amazing player. Three-time MVP, four-time, 14-time All-Star. Won a World Series with the Yankees in 2009. Incredible player. You also had someone like Torii Hunter. Not a Hall of Famer, but in my opinion, he's a Hall of Greater. Just a really, really good player. Incredible defense from him. Just a solid all-around outfielder. One of the best outfielders in the game at one point when he was with the Twins. Still remember when Torii Hunter robbed Barry Bonds that All-Star game. That was awesome. Five-time All-Star, 9-time Gold Glove. I mean, you just had to love Torii Hunter, man. He was one of the best players in the game at one point. And speaking of the best, how about one of the best closers of all time, Billy Wagner? I mean, my goodness, guy had over 400 saves. A lot of people think he should be in the Hall of Fame. He would get my vote. This guy was absolutely incredible. He had a career ERA of 2.31. He had a career FIP of 2.73. So, my goodness, Billy Wagner. Let's get this guy in the Hall of Fame. I'm like, my God. How about Chris Carpenter? This guy was really good. He had some health issues in his career, but helped win a couple of World Series with the Cardinals, had a Cy Young Award, three-time All-Star. This guy was insanely good in his career. Over 350 games in his career, 332 games started, 2,200 innings there, 3.76 career ERA. Winning the Cy Young in 2005 for the St. Louis Cardinals. He got third that next year in 2006. Second place in 2009 with the Cardinals. He was extremely good. There was that one year he did miss because I believe he had Tommy John or something with his shoulder. I can't fully remember. But Chris Carpenter, easily one of the better pitchers in the game at one point. Derek Lee. How about Derek Lee, man? Look at the numbers this guy put up in 2005. I honestly think this guy had a legitimate argument to win the MVP that year. He hit 335 with a 662 slugging, a 418 on base. He had 46 home runs, 107 RBIs. My goodness, Derek Lee, I was shocked when he didn't win the MVP that year. He had some really good seasons there with the Cubs. My goodness. How about Jason Varitek? And Trot Nixon helping my Red Sox win the World Series in 2004. I always just loved Trot Nixon. He was my favorite player at one point. Jason Varitek, the captain. My goodness, helping the Red Sox win a couple of World Series there in 04 and 07. Jason Varitek, a legend in Red Sox history. This is just such a good draft. I mean, you led by an amazing player like Alex Rodriguez, and then sprinkled in with a lot of solid guys here. In my opinion, it's one of the best drafts of all time, 1993. At number three, I have the 2005 draft. Oh my goodness, there was so much depth in this first round. What the heck is going on here in this first round? Look at some of these names. You had Alex Gordon. You had Justin Upton. You had Ryan Zimmerman. You had Ryan Braun. Troy Tulowitzki. Andrew McCutchen, even someone like Jay Bruce was pretty solid. My goodness, Jacoby Ellsbury was in this draft. Ryan Braun was one of the most fun players in baseball at one point, had himself a really solid career. Andrew McCutchen still hanging around. He is playing. He was one of the most fun players in the game. Really enjoyed Andrew McCutchen when he was on the Pittsburgh Pirates. How about Ryan Zimmerman, just recently retired, helping the Nationals win the World Series in 2019, had himself a really solid career. How about Justin Upton? We talked about BJ Upton earlier. Justin Upton at one point was extremely solid. I mean, look at some of these years that he was having with the Diamondbacks, with the Atlanta Braves, with the Padres, with the Tigers. He's kind of flamed out now with the Angels, but he had some really good years. How about Alex Gordon helping win in the World Series in 2015 with the Kansas City Royals? He was an extremely solid player. Never one of the best players in the game, but just a dirt dog kind of a player. Kind of reminded me of Trot Nixon in a way. Troy Tulowitzki, this guy was considered arguably the best shortstop in the game at one point. He was absolutely insane. This guy was extremely good offensively and defensively with the Colorado Rockies, getting to the World Series in 2007, won Rookie of the Year, he got second place in Rookie of the Year that year. That was the year the Rockies made it to the World Series to go against my Red Sox, which they lost. I digress. But he was an extremely good player for quite a while. And then don't forget about Jacoby Ellsbury. I understand when he went to the Yankees, he basically just fell off a cliff, but some of the years that he was having with the Red Sox, 2011, are you kidding me? He got second place in MVP voting. He hit 321 that year with a 376 on base, a 552 slugging, 32 homers, 105 RBIs. He had 39 stolen bases. What the heck is going on with Jacoby Ellsbury? I mean, this guy was so good with the Red Sox. Just all of these players. Now, you didn't have a Hall of Famer in here. I don't think there's going to be a guy out of this draft that gets into the Hall of Fame, but you just had so much depth in this draft, and that's why I think it edges out the 93 draft just a little bit. You had A-Rod there, but there's just so many good players in this draft. A heck of a draft in 2005 in that first round. At number two, I have the 2011 draft. What the heck is going on with this first round? You want depth? I just talked about depth with 2005, but you want depth? Here's some depth for you. Are you kidding me? We got Gerrit Cole. He's one of the best pitchers in all of Major League Baseball right now. There's Trevor Bauer. I understand he's not in the game right now, but I think he will be back eventually. Trevor Bauer, yes, he's not in the game, but during his time up to this point, he has been one of the more solid pitchers in all of Major League Baseball. I understand Anthony Rendon. He's got the wrist issue right now. He's out for the whole year. He's one of the worst contracts as of right now. But Anthony Rendon has had a really solid career up to this point, you know, minus like, you know, his time with the Angels, really. But with the Nationals, he was extremely good. Francisco Lindor, tough first year with the Mets, but holy crap, some of the years that he was putting up with the Cleveland Indians, it was really good. And he's doing a lot better this year than he was last year. I think he's going to continue to be very solid for the New York Mets in his career. Javier Baez, he got off to a slow start this year, but he's been one of the more fun players in the game with the Cubs. Lots of power there from Javier Baez. He has been heating up with the bat lately, but Javier Baez, one of the more solid players in the game. Very good glove as well. How about George Springer? Signing with the Blue Jays not too long ago. Some very good years with the Astros there, helping win the World Series in 2017. Four-time All-Star. He was the World Series MVP in 2017. How about Brandon Nimmo? I think one of the more underrated players in the game. I think he deserves a lot more attention. He's an on-base machine. Jose Fernandez, unfortunately, had the tragic passing. I do think if he were still with us today, I think he would be one of the best pitchers in Major League Baseball. His stuff was just absolutely insane. Through 76 starts, a 2.58 ERA. He had 589 strikeouts over 471 and a third innings. Jose Fernandez was that good, man. Tragic event. Sonny Gray having himself a really good year with the Twins this year. There's just so much depth in this first round. When you look at the combined wins above replacements from this draft and 2005. 2005 has a slight edge as of right now, but when all is said and done, this draft class is going to surpass that one in terms of WAR. There's just so many good players. I mean, even Dylan Bundy, he ended up not really being the pitcher that people thought he would end up being, but he's been having an okay year this year. I mean, there's just a lot. Even Matt Barnes, I understand his best times are past him, but at one point, a extremely good reliever. There's also Colton Wong, one of the better gloves in this game. Well, look at Blake Swihart. My goodness, I haven't seen that name for a while. But this is an extremely good draft, and it's still going. That's what's scary about it, man. So 2011, I have that coming in at number two. Let's see who I have at number one. And at number one, I have the 1985 draft. This first round was absolutely bonkers. Look at some of the names here in this draft. We got to start off with Barry Bonds, who I think is the best player of all time. Steroids or not, I don't care what you say, this guy's numbers were absolutely off the charts. Seven-time MVP, 14-time All-Star, won a home run derby at one point as well. Eight-time gold glove, two-time batting title, 12-time silver slugger. What the heck? Barry Bonds, are you kidding me? All-time home run leader, almost 2,000 RBIs. He had a career on-base percentage of .444, a .607 career slugging. Holy cow, man. This guy's numbers. I mean, I could sit here for hours and just look at these numbers. There's a lot of bold numbers here. There's a lot of italic. I'm not even going to get into it because this video will go on for another 20 minutes. This guy was absolutely insane. They were walking this guy with the bases loaded because they didn't want to face this guy. He was absolutely incredible with the Pirates and with the Giants. Just insane, man. Absolutely insane. Again, the career leader in home runs, has the most walks of all time in his career. Over 2,500 walks. What the heck is going on, Barry Bonds? Holy cow, man. Whatever. Barry Larkin, Hall of Famer, an extremely solid player in his career. For his career, hitting .295, a 960 RBIs, almost 400 stolen bases, a career on base of .471. Just an extremely good player with the Cincinnati Reds. In all 19 years of his career with the Cincinnati Reds, won an MVP in 1995. Just a very good player, offensively, defensively as well. He was just fantastic. There's also Rafael Palmeiro, numbers-wise, he should be in the Hall of Fame, but then there was the whole steroid scandal thing. Same thing with Barry Bonds. That's why he's not in it as well. Rafael Palmeiro, he made the mistake of going up there in front of people and pointing his finger saying, I never took steroids, and then he ended up getting busted for steroids. But Rafael Palmeiro, nonetheless, extremely good numbers in his career. Hit 288 for his career, had 569 home runs, just over 1,800 RBIs, a career 371 on base, 515 slugging, an extremely good player. Yes, I understand the steroid scandal, but hey, not going to take anything away from these numbers, man. Very good numbers. There was even someone like Will Clark, who at one point with the San Francisco Giants, man, he was a really good player. He was putting up very good numbers. I mean, take a look at the year that he had in 1998, had over 100 RBIs. He had back-to-back seasons with over 100 RBIs. Really solid stretch here from 1998 to 1992, playing really good defense out there as well. Will Clark, I think, one of the more underrated players in the history of the game, just an on-base machine. Very good, productive player. There's even someone like BJ Surhoff, who I also think is a pretty underrated player. I mean, take a look at the numbers. There's nothing really incredibly flashy. You know, under 200 home runs, just over 1,100 RBIs, but just a really solid player in his career, a career WAR of 34.4. This is a guy that just go out there and just play every day. He was just a reliable player, just really solid overall. Just a guy that you liked having on your team. To me, the fact that you had this first round with guys like Barry Bonds, Barry Larkin, and Rafael Palmeiro, I mean, that is just insane. Barry Bonds definitely carries it. I think eventually this 2011 draft could end up surpassing this one. As of right now, the 1985 first round has a combined wins above replacement of 495.9, while right now the 2011 draft is more closer to around 405. So it's going to be interesting to see if that draft class can surpass this. But as of right now, you have to give it to this draft class. When you have these three amazing players that came out of it, what a first round that was. So that's my list. Tell me what you think down below. Do you think any of these first rounds should be up higher, lower? Do you think I should have added some different first rounds into this list? Tell me what you think down below. But that's all I have for right now. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you next time.